lower than Brahmaloka. Because in the Puranas, you must have heard, I must have told you also, above Bhuloka, the higher loka is supposed to be Bhuvar Loka, Mahar Loka, Dena Loka, Tapo Loka, and Satya Loka or Brahma Loka. Brahma Loka is the highest loka through which the Upasaka will get Krama Mukti, but the ritualist will never go to Brahma Loka. They will go to only the lower lokas. Lower lokas in anartam, between Bhuloka and Brahma Loka, all those intermediary lokas are called Swarga Lokas. And that Swarga Loka he reaches. And this Krishna Marga is also presided over by devatas. And who are those devatas? The list is given. Don't ask me, how do you know? We have not seen. It is all described in the Veda. And we accept Veda because Veda does not lie unlike us. Nammala madri kadaiyadu. Veda tells the truth. And therefore, it is truth only. What are the devatas? Dhumaha, Dhuma Devata, literally the word Dhuma means smoke, but here it is the name of the Devata, Dhuma Devata. Ratrihi, literally means night, but here it refers to Ratri Devata. Similarly, Krishnaha, Krishnaha in this context means Krishna Paksha Devata, not Vasudeva Krishna. Here Krishna means Krishna Paksha Devata. Krishna Paksha means what? The dark fortnight. And then Shanmasa Dakshinayanam, Dakshinayana Devata. So these four devatas are given as a sample in the Upanishad, especially in Chandogya and Brihadaranyaka, the list is more extensive. Narayakudutiruka, Krishna here gives only a few as a sample. And guided by these four devatas, this person will go to Swarga Loka. And if he is going to go to Swarga Loka, why do you call it a gloomy path? Shouldn't it be a brighter path? Surgatuku poradunnale ellara santoshama thane pohana. People should be happy. Why do you call the path to heaven as dark paths? Krishna says the reason is prapya nivartate. The bad news is that he will go and enjoy all right. But once the punya gets exhausted, he will come down, becoming more miserable. Because here our body is very much used to mosquitoes, very much used to our corporation water in which all kinds of things are mixed up, including sewage water. And in spite of taking all these things, we survive. And having enjoyed better health in Swarga, the moment you come down, mosquito bite and cold, that is how it is. And not only that, even you don't enjoy that because you will count down. So, I will come soon, I will come soon, I will come soon. Therefore, it is not bright compared to Krama Mukti. So, compared to Shukla Marga, Krishna Marga is certainly inferior and therefore it is dark, like the black spot in the sun. Really speaking, the black spot is not black spot at all. It is very bright. But it is called a black spot because compared to other parts, it appears black. Similarly, Krishna Marga is blacker are darker compared to Shuklagati. So thus, we have got the second marga, which is called Krishna marga. And who is the traveler? Yogi. And in this verse, carefully note, the word yogi means a ritualist. Non-upasaka ritualist is called yogi in this verse. In Sanskrit, karmi, or to be precise, kevala karmi. And now Krishna sums up these two margas in the next verse. Shukla Krishne gati hyete. Jagatashashvate mate. Ekayayatyana vrittim. Anyaya vartate punaha. So Krishna is giving the name in this shloka only. In the previous two shlokas, he indicated the presiding devatas, but not the name of the paths. He gives the name here. Yete gati shukla krishne. These two paths are known by the name shukla. You have to add the gati. Shukla gatihi and krishna gatihi. Otherwise shukla marga and krishna marga. Otherwise devayanam and pitriyanam. And when were these two roads created? He says, Jagataha Shashvate Mate. These two margas have been created along with the universe, not in between, like putting a new road. After creation, Bhagavan thought, rendu road podrome solli. No, it is not a later added route. But along with the creation itself, these roots have been made because along with the creation, Veda has come. And along with the creation, the karma upasana teaching also has been given. And along with the creation, human beings also have come. And therefore, along with the creation, these two types of sadhakas are also there. Therefore, these two margas must be there. And therefore, jagataha shashvate mate. These are two eternal paths which come along with the creation and which will go only at the time of pralayam. And again, when the next srishti comes, again, these two margas will come. Therefore, they are as eternal as the universe itself. And of these two margas, ekaya anavrittim yati. By following one path, which one? You cannot put anyone. Shuklaya. Ekaya means shuklaya gatya. By following Shukla Gati, anavrittim yati, a person will get krama muktihi by going via Brahmaloka. Brahmaloka is the transit point. Solalalila, London la nukkaradu, Frankfurt la nukkaradu, ilan solalalila. Maru Brahmaloka thil oru stopover and then moksha, krama mukti. Jivan mukti means direct flight. Edela, enga stop over kadaya. Straight flight. Not like Indian Airlines, okay. So, ekaya anavrittim yati anyaya. Through the other one, krishnaya gatya. So, here the word anavritti refers to krama mukti, ishvara prapti. the goal of non-return. And anyaya, through the other paths, that is Krishnaya gatya, avartate punaha, a person will definitely go to Swargaloka, because even though he has not done upasana, he has done noble karmas, he has done service to the society, he has done lot of puja, he has done duties. Therefore, certainly he has acquired punyam, therefore he will go to Swargaloka. But the minus point is what? Having exhausted, he will avartate come back. Avartate punaha. And here, the previous two verses have got certain confusing aspects, and therefore these two verses are discussed in Brahma Sutra. Wherever there is a possible confusion in Gita or Upanishad, Brahma Sutra will analyze and resolve the confusion. What is the confusion? In the previous two shlokas, Krishna mentions Uttarayanam and Shukla Paksha and daytime, and Krishna says whoever dies in those times, Uttarayana Kale or Shukla Pakshe or Ahaha daytime, a person will go to Kramamukti. So the confusion that can come is, we may think the time of death will determine whether we will get Shukla Gati or Krishna Gati. If you read the words superficially, it appears as though you die in Uttarayanam, you die in Shukla Paksha, or you die during daytime, you will get the Shukla Gati. Similarly, if you study the 25th verse, it appears as though you die in Dakshinayanam, Krishna Paksha, or night time, it appears as though you will get Krishna Gati. Therefore, it appears as though the time of death will determine the direction of travel. Because the word Kala is used there. After elaborate analysis in Brahma Sutra, it has been established that time of death does not determine the direction of the journey, but it is the quality of life that determines the direction of the journey. It is not the time of death at all. And several arguments are given. I am not going to the details. Just one argument is this. In the 24th verse, Uttarayanam, Shukla Paksha, and daytime are mentioned. And in the 25th verse, Dakshinayanam, Krishna Paksha, and Ratri are mentioned. Suppose a person dies in Uttarayana Krishna Paksha. Because according to 24th verse, Uttarayana Maranam means Shukla Gati. According to 25th verse, Krishna Paksha Maranam is Krishna Gati. Uttarayana Tala Krishna Paksham Irukuma Irukada. Basic doubt varapadade. So Bhagavan will be confused. Similarly, according to 24th verse, Shukla Paksha Maranam, Shukla Paksha is Uttarayana, suppose we take. And according to 25th, night time is given as indicative of Krishna Gati. Suppose a person dies during Shukla Paksha Ratrihi. Na Shukla Pakshatla Ratri Varma Varada, Sandevali. Shukla Paksha Ratri, a person dies, according to 24th verse, Shukla Paksha Maranam should give Shukla Gati. And according to 25th verse, Ratri Maranam should give Krishna Gati. Shukla Paksha Ratri Maranam, confusion varo. Adhanala, never interpret these two slokas as referring to the time of death at all. And not only that, if the time of death will determine higher goal, there will be problem. How many criminals die in Uttarayana? Ellarkum Shukla Gati. And how many saints die in Dakshinayana? Avalukkellam Krishna Gati aachuna enna gati aaradhu? And not only that, people can do akramams and commit suicide in Uttarayana. Still easier. Enna krama mukti kadathidum. Like LTT people, potassium cyanide kadikka vendiyadha. So therefore, time of death will not determine your future. It is the quality of life. This is the conclusion made in Brahma Sutra. And Krishna himself makes it very clear in 26th verse, Shukla Krishne Gati Hyete. They refer to Marga, not the time at all. Continuing. Naite Sriti Partha Janan. Yogi Muhyati Kaschana. Tasmat Sarveshu Kaleshu. Yoga Yukto Bhavarjuna. So here Krishna says, Arjuna, I have talked about two destinations, two paths, and two types of travelers very clearly. Having known the difference between these two, Yete Sriti Janan. Sriti means what? Gati. Gati means what? Margau. So, Etau Margau Janan. Having clearly known these two paths. In what way? One path leading to better future, Krama Mukti. Other path leading to only inferior future, Punarjanma. Having clearly understood, Yogi Kaschanana Muhyati, an intelligent seeker will never get confused. An intelligent seeker will never vote for the wrong path, like election. Therefore, the Republicans also have given this speech. The Democrats also has given this speech. Rendu kudutachu. Now, you have to choose the right one. Anga confusion nadakkirathu, inge nadakkapadadhu. So therefore, yogi means viveki, an intelligent seeker will not get confused with regard to karma marga and upasana marga, whether I should become a mere ritualist or whether I should add upasana also. So whether I should become a karmi or whether I should become upasaka, such a doubt should not come to an intelligent seeker. And Arjuna, you come under which group, intelligent or unintelligent? Krishna says, Arjuna, I assume that you are an intelligent seeker. Therefore, what should you do? Become upasaka. Tasmat Sarveshu Kaleshu. And therefore, Arjuna, may you choose upasana. No doubt you have to do karma. No doubt you have to do your duties. No doubt, pancha maha yajnas are there. Let karma go on, but add to your karma saguna ishvara upasana also. Therefore, sarveshu kaleshu, at all times, beginning from now onwards, yoga yuktaha bhava. Here, yoga means what? Saguna ishvara upasana yuktaha bhava. So, may you choose upasana. So, here we should be very careful. When I am asked to choose between karma and upasana, I have to choose upasana. But remember, in the 8th chapter of the Gita, jnanam is not contesting the election. If jnanam comes